Good evening and welcome to each one of you to this awesome session of Mindful Living. We truly appreciate your taking out the time and joining the session today when an India-Pakistan match is going on. And your joining the session today is a clear demonstration of your intention to be a super learner and take your life to the next level. All sessions of Mindful Living are guaranteed to improve your quality of life, and today's session is no different. Friends, Alvin Toffler says that the illiterate of the 21st century will not be those who cannot read or write, but those who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn. We are all witnessing a very rapid pace of transformation in the world that we live in. And it is imperative for us to be able to learn, unlearn, and relearn at a very fast pace. Unfortunately, our educational system encourages learning by rote, and that is something which will not help us deal with the society and the world that we are living in today. Today, we need to just run to stay in the same place. So that is the reason we've organized the session today on super learning by Deepti Gupta and Sanjeev Ji. Sanjeev Ji is an engineer and an MBA who has worked with organizations like 3M, Xerox, and Toyota. In his last corporate assignment, he was working as the CEO of an organization based out of East Africa. He has the distinction of being featured in the Limca Book of Records for spearheading a CSR initiative that touched over 4 lakh human lives through a health and hygiene campaign. He's a certified expert on English, employability, and entrepreneurship by MEPSC, Government of India, has been a visiting faculty for top management institutions like Symbiosis and Presidency. He is joined by his partner, life partner, and business partner, Deepti Gupta. Deepti is a cognitive skill development trainer who has mastered the art of alignment and application of powers of the subconscious and conscious mind. Friend, this may sound like English, but there is a lot of depth in this one statement. Our subconscious mind is about 90% of our mind, and conscious is about 5 to 10%. And most often, they may not be working in an aligned fashion, and that's the cause of so many challenges that we face in our lives today. Today, Sanjeev Ji and Deepti will take us through a very powerful process which can help us in aligning the conscious and subconscious mind and become a super learner. What does a super learner mean? I will not share that. I'll let Sanjeev Ji and Deepti talk about what does super learning mean and what is the implication. You know, once we become a super learner, how does it help us as a professional, as a parent, as a student, and in each area of our life? Deepti Ji is a graduate from Delhi University and has got a diploma in fashion designing. She is also an EEE expert. Sanjeev Ji and Deepti Ji, welcome to the program. We really appreciate your taking out time and joining us today. Friends, some of you are joining a Mindful Living session for the first time. Please type FT for first time if you're joining a Mindful Living session for the first time. Type FT in the chat box if you are joining a Mindful Living session for the first time. Thank you, Rafiq. So for the benefit, thank you, Uma Maheshwar. For the benefit of those who are joining our session for the first time, let me take a minute to introduce myself. My name is Ashish Kumar, and I'm the founder of Mindful Living Community. The Mindful Living Community started in April 2020 during the first lockdown. Few of my friends reached out to me and requested me to conduct a session on mindfulness for them to help them deal with the stress and anxiety that the lockdown was causing. Being a certified mindfulness meditation teacher myself, I conducted a session on mindfulness for my friends. One thing led to the other, and today we have become a vibrant community of over 3,000 professionals who connect every weekend to learn about practicing mindfulness in our daily lives. You can join this community only by invitation, and I would love to invite you to join the community using the link in the chat. This is a very safe space for people to come and learn, share about living mindfully. There are no good morning, good night messages, no political messages, no religious messages. So please come join us and benefit from the awesome sessions like the one that we are conducting today. Few groundkeeping rules before we invite Sanjeev ji and Deepti ji to take the session forward. Please keep a notepad and book handy. We will also be doing a small activity during the session for which I'll request for 4 volunteers. So please keep your cameras on and have your notepad and pen ready. Also, this is not a podcast which you can watch by switching off your camera, nor is it a TV show where you can lean back and just enjoy. Remain actively engaged. We will take question answers towards the end of the session, but you can use the reactions button to show your appreciation, thumbs up, clap, or show love, or put your questions in the chat. We'll be tracking the questions and we'll be taking them towards the end of the session. So on that note, Sanjeev ji and Deepti ji, welcome to the session, and I request you to take this forward from here.
Sanjeev
thank
ji.
Thank you, Ashish bhai. Thank you.
Thank you.
And Deepti ji, happy morning. Yeah.
Good to see you, sir. Good to see you.
Yeah, how is your two princes?
All good, all good. Very, both of them very, are doing well. Thank you so much for remembering. So, very good evening, friends. Ashish ji, thank you so much for this opportunity and for the lovely introduction. It is always a pleasure and my deepest gratitude to you and to all my friends who are here. Because I know today is a big day. After such a long time, India and Pakistan are contesting, teeth to teeth. And friends who are here, I can understand the kind of sacrifice they are making on their fun time, entertainment time and all that. Having said that, it's a pleasure to be in this community. And it also gives me an opportunity to welcome you all who are not part of this wonderful, wonderful, amazing community and initiative started by Ashish Bhai and many other very enlightened people who are there to willing and help and contribute and communicate so much of a wealth of information that every time you attend these sessions, you really grow. Besides networking, connecting with some of the finest people, souls and minds. So anybody who is not part of this community, kindly don't delay it. You have only to gain from this. So on that note, thank you once again, everyone, for being here. So with me is Deepti, and both of us are going to take you through this session in the next 45 minutes to 1 hour, and we will take your questions, as many of them we can. As Ashish Bhai said, that we are now going to talk about super learning. Now, super learning is a term that we have coined. It's our homegrown term. And what does super learning do? Super learning is actually a cognitive skill. It's a mind skill which helps to enhance and boost the powers of the brain. What do we mean by that? We mean that it helps to enhance our cognitive abilities such as observation, perception, memory, recall, problem solving, and decision making. In simple terms, if I have to add one line to this, super learning is a program or a skill which helps to enhance our quantum of learning, speed of learning, and accuracy of learning. These three important phenomena are immediately and simultaneously addressed by super learning. And this happens because we are able to work on our natural abilities of focus and visualization. Now, in our experience of the academic life and even in professional life, most of my friends probably would agree with me that everybody expects us to be more focused, be more attentive, be more mindful of ourselves. We expect in turn from our children to be more focused in whatever they are doing, especially in their studies. And if they're good at sports, to be even better in sports by being more attentive. The key question is, how do we focus? That is the key question. Somehow in the entire chase of educating ourselves, most of our institutions have missed this important piece in the whole information. Most of the schools, I would say that there are hardly any school teaches the students or the children to be more focused. How do you do about it? How do you go about it? So there's an expectation without a backup, without a plan. We are expecting our children to be more focused. Just think about it. How if our children turn around while we are telling them, okay, Baba, you should be more focused. They turn around and they ask me, okay, Dad, I want to be focused. Can you teach me how to focus? Just think about it. If they turn around and ask you, I'm ready to be focused. Can you please teach me a few techniques how to be focused? Which can actually be translated into objective with objectivity and with certainty. So this is the question which we would like to address today. And we would like to know there's nothing better to do it and demonstrate it through an example. So to cut the chase, I would straight away get to the demonstration, because that will help to highlight a lot of things about what would happen if we are able to focus better, visualize better. There was one line in the introduction about alignment of the conscious and the subconscious mind. And I would like to draw your attention to this point. What would happen if both our minds, the conscious mind and the subconscious mind, are aligned to each other? When they start talking to each other, when they start reciprocating to each other, what is the kind of immense power that we are going to generate and demonstrate is what you are going to see in this program. So there are a few other things which I would like to address, but that I'll do after the demonstration so that the suspense doesn't get over. So Ashiji, with this introduction, I would request you to help me with four volunteers whom we can, pick up initially, and then we will open the floor for everyone.
Surely, Sanjeevji. Friends, we need four volunteers. It's a very simple activity, nothing very complex. Very, very simple. All you need is a pen and paper with you. If you have a pen and paper, or you have access to pen and paper, and you can keep your camera on, or even if you don't keep your camera on, it's okay. But just raise your hand using the reactions button, and then, okay, thank you, SNL. Thank you, Ajinji. We need two more. Two more volunteers, please raise your hands. All right. Maybe Sanjeevji, is it okay if we work with Hassan and Rajendraji?
Yeah, we have Sureshji.
So we have three now. Suresh also. Good.
And Arshana. Yeah, I'm also ready.
Okay.
I'm also ready. Uma Maheshwar.
So we have five now.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Okay. Great. So we have five volunteers. And so let me start with, so if we have our volunteers and if they can switch on their videos, nothing like it. But if you are more comfortable with that switched off, that's fine. So let me start with Mr. Hassan Ali. And I will give instructions to each one of you. This instructions will be for the person whose name is called out. They will be slightly different for each one of you. So kindly, it has to be followed only by the person whose name is called out. And then I will call out other names subsequently. So I'll be starting with Mr. Hassan Ali. Sir, I'm assuming you are having a pen and a paper ready with you, right, sir? Okay. So if this is the piece of paper that you have, on this, I will request you to write numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, right up to 8. 1 to 8 in sequence vertically. And against each number, please write one simple word in English. It could be like bottle, milk, water, pen, paper, corona, whatever comes to your mind. Random. But it should be a simple word. So you will have 8 numbers and 8 words in English, one against each number. Right, sir? Ready? Please go ahead. You may do that. Rainder, sir. Rainderji? Yeah, sir, you may do the same thing, but you will do for serial number 9 to 16. 9, 10, 11, 12, up to 16. Numbers 9 to 16 vertically without missing a number and one simple word in English against each number. Right, sir? Okay, great. Suresh ji, you will do it from 17 to 24. 1-7, 17 to 24. Same thing, 17 to 24, one word in English against that, each number. Okay. Mr. Uma Maheshwar, you will do it from, yes, sir, from 25 to 32. 25, 26, 27, up to 32, and one word in English against that, right? And Archana ma'am, you will do it from 33 to 40. Archana ji, I hope you are there.
Yeah, I'm listening.
Great, ma'am. So serial number 33 to 40, vertically down, and one word against each number. Once you are done, do let me know, please. Great. So now since you have done, the people who have done it, I'm assuming you have Ashish ji's number with you, the WhatsApp number.
I have also typed it in the chat. It is 9899-77266.
You may save his number and you have to take a good, nice picture of this and please forward it to Ashish bhai. Okay. All the friends who may have joined late, we are going to talk about super learning today. Super learning is a cognitive skill which helps us to be more mindful. It helps us to align the powers of the conscious mind and the subconscious mind. And in this session, over the next 15-20 minutes, we are going to show you live what is the power our brain has. And if we know how to align these two minds, what is the kind of impact we can make on our performance in any area of our life? So we'll talk about it later, but I just wanted to set the context that what we are going to witness in the next 15 to 20 minutes. So for this, we are going to have a live demo right now. We have with us five volunteers who have helped us in this demonstration. We have Mr. Hassan Ali, Mr. Rajendra Arora, Mr. Suresh Kumar, Mr. Uma Maheshwar, and Archana ma'am. So Suresh ji, you are done with those words. And how about Mr. Uma Maheshwar? Are you done, sir? So can you just forward it to Ashish bhai, Archana ma'am, you too?
Oh, we have to take a photo and send it, huh? Okay.
Yeah. Just take a good, nice picture of this to Ashish bhai.
In the group, we can post it, right?
That is up to Ashish bhai to decide.
You can post it in the group also.
Yeah, that's
just let me know which group you're posting it on.
Ashish sir, I have posted it to your personal number.
Got it. So I've got from Hassan Ali, I have got from Uma Maheshwar. I have got from Archana, Rajendra ji, and okay, just forwarding it to you.
Okay, yeah. So Ashish bhai, you have got them?
Yeah, just sending them to you.
Okay. Okay, so I have got it. 16. Okay, so we have got the words from 1 to 8, 8 to it's 9 to 16, 17 to 24, 25 to 32, and this one, let me just rotate it. Okay, so friends, let's get into it. Now, from this point onwards, all our friends who are there on the group, the entire group of friends who are there on this session with us, everybody can participate. So what we have done, we have taken 40 words from 5 volunteers here who have helped us with this. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to read these words thrice from 1 to 40 in the same sequence in which they have been given to me. 1 to 8 by Mr. Hassan Ali, 9 to 16 by Rajendra Ji, 17 to 24 by Suresh Ji, then Mr. Uma Maheshwar from 25 to 32, and from 33 to 40 by Arjuna Ma'am. I'm going to read them thrice. After reading them thrice, there are two questions which I'm going to ask my friends here. Question number one. Out of the 40 words, how many words can you recollect? Sequence is not important. Question number two. How many words can you recollect in the same sequence in which they were spoken? While I am reading these words, you are free to use whatever method you want to use, but try to use your power of focus to get that. Focus is something that we have been doing since, or we have been hearing right from age 5 onwards, correct? We have been talking about it. We have been hearing about it. So if we are about 30, 35, 40 years of age, imagine the number of years we have been practicing it. So using that power of focus, we have to try to remember as many words. That is the exercise. In case you miss out any word, don't worry. I'm going to read them thrice. So just calmly hear those words. And these are the two questions I'm going to ask. Now, you are not supposed to tell the words. You have to just tell a number. For example, I think I can recollect 20 words. I think I can recollect 25 to 30 words. That number is important. Nobody is going to ask you the word. Okay. This is for you to know. After you have got this, I'm going to share the global outcome of this experiment, which is going on since 1952. So you are participating in an experiment which is on since 1952, and the world's top psychologists and neuroscientists do it. Of course, I've slightly tweaked it so that it becomes more engaging. Now, after this, and after you have shared your results, I'm going to share the result of that global average where millions of people have attended it over the last 75 years. Now, what will happen after that? So you will have your own result, unadulterated, unambiguous. You will have the global result. Now, from there will come certain outcomes. And after that, we'll get to the next level of this session, right? Everybody clear with the activity? So here we begin. Let me start with the first word. Okay, the first word is, starting from the first word, I accept everyone. The fourth word is as. They, the fifth word is they. Sixth is are. Seventh word is great. And the eighth word is done. So let me repeat that. I accept everyone as they are, great, done. Done is the eighth word. Love, blessings, gratitude, sincere, honest, abundance, compassion. Compassion is the 15th word. Bliss, you have to help me with the 17th word. Suresh ji?
Ramesh.
It is okay. Ramesh. I guessed that, but I thought I must be clear. So 17th word is Ramesh. Book, table, reading. Reading is the 20th word. Drinking, writing, pen, paper. Paper is the 24th word. All possible, billionaire, creative, easy, friend, gratitude. Gratitude is the 30th word. Happy, identity. Glass, bottle, shoe. Shoe is the 35th word. Fish, table, plant, camera, ocean. Ocean is the 40th word. The last word is ocean. So we'll go through the list the second time. I accept everyone as they are. Great, done. Love, blessings. Blessings is the 10th word. Gratitude, sincere, honest, abundance, compassion, bliss, Ramesh, book, table, reading. Reading is the 20th word. Drinking, writing, pen, paper, all possible, billionaire, creative, easy, friend, gratitude. Gratitude is the 30th word. Happy, identity, glass, bottle, shoe, fish, table, plant, camera, ocean. Ocean is the last word. So the third and the final time, I accept everyone as they are. Great, done, love, blessings, gratitude, sincere, honest, abundance, compassion, bliss, Ramesh, book, table, reading, drinking, writing, pen, paper, all possible, billionaire, creative, easy, friend, gratitude, happy, identity, glass, bottle, shoe, fish, table, plant, camera, and the last word is ocean. Okay. So these are the 40 words. So as we said, the first question is, how many words do you think you can recall? You can just put your number on the chat box. 5, 15, 20, 25, 35, all 40, whatever comes to your mind. Whatever it comes to you. You don't have to recall the word. That number itself is good enough. It is more for you to know, okay, this is my score from that word. Okay, so 15, 17, 30, very nice, Archanaji. 13, very good, great. So if we can have some more responses, that would be great because everybody could have participated in this. Okay, now out of these 15, wonderful, Ashish Bhai. So now the second question is, how many of these words can you recall in the same sequence in which they were spoken from 1 to 40? Okay, very good. Vidyaji writes 8, then we have 10. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. 5, 8, very nice, very nice, very nice. So generally when I do it and we have a lot of people, generally you will see the answer to the first question I'm just giving from the group will come in the range of 20 to 25. Almost 80 to 85% will respond in the range of 20 to 25. When asked, the second question is asked, the general opinion is, that's a tough one. 1, 2 here, then the numbers that you spoke, 5, 10, 15, 20, all put together, 7, 8, maybe 10, I'm not sure. Generally, this is the answer. Great. So this is the general answer. Now, when this experiment is, now I'm going to share with you what is the result of that global experiment. When this experiment is done, it is done actually two ways differently than the way I have tweaked it. In the original experiment, there is the presenter brings the words. No, the words are not taken from the audience. That means audience have absolutely no clue of what is going to come their way. That is difference number one. The second difference is the words are spoken only once, not thrice. That means they have one and only chance to grasp the word, correct? Of course, the results are different. Now, the interesting part is in 1950s, 60s, and 70s, it was found that no matter who the audience is, the result was limited between 7 to 9 words, and that too randomly, not in a sequence. So no matter who the audience is, the words were, number of words were limited between 7 to 9 words. In today's day and age, it has come between 4 to 7 words. Let me say that again. So when 40 words are spoken to somebody, people who do not know the words, the words are spoken only once, the result is between 4 to 7 words. Now, what is the conclusion? The conclusion is most of us process the information in a similar form. Second conclusion is there is very limited information that we process. Third is we as a community and a humanity are getting distracted progressively over a period of time, which we know. But this is one of the key outcomes amongst many others. But these are something which I would like to share with you. Now, in this whole process, where does super learning fall into the picture? So Deepti is trained on super learning. Is there somebody who has written down all the 40 words? Anybody who has written down all the 40 words? So Hasan Bhai has all the 40 words. So Hasan Ji, you are an examiner for us. For the next 2 minutes, 3 minutes, you are examining us. So Deepti is trained on super learning. She is going to close her eyes and she is going to speak out. Let's see what she can do with the 40 words, right? Okay, Deepti, can you start?
Yeah, hello friends. So I'm closing my eyes now and I'll be starting from the first word. The first word is I. After that is accept. Third is everyone. I accept everyone. Fourth one is as, then is they. After they is are, then is great. After great is done, then is love, blessings, gratitude, sincere, honest, abundance, compassion, then is bliss, Ramesh, book, table, reading, drinking, writing, pen, paper, then is all possible, billionaire, creative, after creative is easy, friend, gratitude, happy, identity, glass, bottle, shoe, fish, table, plant, camera, and the last word is ocean.
Yes, Hasan sir, were they correct?
All are correct.
Very good. Thank you, sir. So coming back to the definition of super learning is a cognitive skill which helps in enhancing our quantum, speed, accuracy of learning. All the 40 words, quantum, speed, just 3 iterations, and we can see the difference. And accuracy, each word at its number, accurately positioned there, right? So this was first demonstration we wanted to show. Now we will go to the second demonstration part of it. Okay, Suresh Bhai, Suresh Ji, I would request our few people to unmute themselves. That would be helpful. Okay, yes, Suresh Ji, anybody else? Yeah. So Suresh Ji, give us any number between 1 to 40. Just speak out any number between 1 to 40.
20.
Okay, number 20. Number 20 is reading.
Hasan Bhai, you have to check whether it is correct.
Yes, yes, yes.
Suresh Bhai, just speak out 3-4 numbers randomly, very quickly.
17.
Yeah.
17 is Ramesh.
30.
30 is gratitude.
Correct.
Is gratitude repeated?
Yeah, gratitude is repeated at number 11 also.
Billionaire is which number, man?
Billionaire is number 26.
Correct.
Okay. Okay, so now we'll move to the third part of the demonstration. So, Rajinder sir, can you unmute yourself? Unmute yourself, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Sir, please help me with any one number between, 30 to 35. Give me one number between 30 to 35.
33.
33. Very good. And give me one number between 15 to 20.
16.
So 33 to 16 in the reverse order.
Okay. Number 33 is glass. Then 32 is identity. 31 is happy. 30th is gratitude. 29th is friend. 28th is easy. 27th is creative. 26th is billionaire. 25 is all possible. 24 is paper. 23 is pen. 22 is writing. 21 is drinking. 20th is reading. 19th is table. 18th is book. 17th is Ramesh. 16th is bliss. 15th is compassion.
That's it. I think that's it. Right, sir? Hasan bhai.
Excellent. Yes, all right.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. So, basically, we started with our discussion about defining superlearning. We talked about mindfulness. So this is the connection between superlearning, mindfulness, and what is the claim? The claim here is that it helps to enhance our performance in all areas of our life. The underlying secret behind the skill is your ability to enhance focus and your ability to enhance your visualization. Now, most of our friends, maybe some of you would have seen it, most of you would have seen it. There's one very important thing that each one of you would have observed: memory, right? Everybody would have observed. Now, and why I'm mentioning this is because most of the time, what is most obvious shields something which is far more valuable and important, but is shrouded by something which is more obvious to us. Memory is very obvious outcome, which we all see. But friends, memory is something that we identify things with in our day-to-day life. You want to buy a mobile? What is the memory? You wanted to buy a digital camera? What is the memory? You wanted to buy your computer? What is the memory? Memory is something. People, students are passing an exam, they need to memorize things, right? You are sitting in a meeting, you need to make a good impression. Unless you know your records, it won't help you, right? So memory is such an important thing. But the key important part is, it is your ability to focus and visualization which gets missed out, right? If having a good memory does not mean that you have a good focus and high power of imagination, but having a good focus and an excellent imagination definitely means that your memory is going to be good. This is one small exercise demonstration to show our case in real life, right? Now, this can be used, and this is from a very generic standpoint. But here, when we are talking about aligning our two minds. We are talking about what she is answering, especially the random number. Let's say, what is number 27? What is that number 27?
Okay, number 27 is creative.
Right, Hasan bhai? Okay. Now, this is something which I've asked her. She didn't know it. Even I didn't know it that I'm going to ask her 27. Now, why did I ask is just to impress upon the point that she is recalling these words from her subconscious mind, not from the conscious mind. Our conscious mind has a very limited memory. If I ask you your number, I'll have to ask you 10 times your mobile number. And ultimately, I will say, Hasan bhai, wait. Let me write it down. Correct? That means our conscious mind, the working memory, is very, very short. It is the subconscious mind, which is the repository, which is the storehouse, which is the warehouse of holding our information. So she's recalling that from the subconscious mind. The key point which I want to mention here is that this whole exercise is to elevate your subconscious mind to a whole new level. But the subconscious mind is reciprocating because her conscious mind is very active and receptive while I'm speaking the words. When I started from the first word to the 40th word, her conscious mind is very, very active, conscious and receptive. The moment its focus goes down, the subconscious, the connect between the subconscious mind will get distorted. I hope this point is clear. So the message, the information is being received by the prefrontal cortex here, which is the conscious part of the mind, and being pushed and received by the subconscious mind. And that is how the two minds are reciprocating and working in tandem with each other. One throwing information, other receiving, assimilating, processing, and then reflecting back when it is required, right? So this is a very simple explanation of the alignment of the conscious and the subconscious mind, and the results are for everyone to see, okay? Now, there is one major question which is asked to me, especially by the educational institution. And here I would say that even the very enlightened people at the highest level of academics get confused. They will ask me, oh, this is some very high level of memorization and rectification. The answer to this is we can't be farther away from the truth. Let me explain this with an example. Anything that you learn without understanding, purely by mugging up and rectification, you cannot pick it up randomly. Let me give an example. The way she picked it up, what is 27, 22, 15, 17? No. If you have not understood, it is impossible. I'll give you an example. We all know our ABCDE. Anybody who doesn't know, everybody knows, right? What is alphabet number 7? What is 14? What is 21? What is 22? What is 8? What is 15? Impossible. Impossible. Correct? Because that is one information we have received. Rectification, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, we have been doing it. But here, each and every word was grasped by understanding it and processing it. So it has all the 360 degrees of freedom. It can be handled individually and it can be connected with the other words individually. That is why I asked, is gratitude repeated? She could immediately tell. The gratitude is repeated at this number and that number. What is number 27? What is number 17? Where is Ramesh? Where is the billionaire? Where are all this can be played around in such a short span of her mind, time by her mind and connecting it. Connecting the dots is another phrase we would have heard. Connecting the dots. Now, what is meant by our bosses have told us in the corporate, boss, you should connect the dots. You should know how to connect. Of course, I should know how to. Can you please teach me? I want to connect the dots. Can somebody teach me how to connect the dots? Which dots are we talking about? Where are the dots? What is the process to connect the dots? The process of connecting the dots is to activate your subconscious mind. These dots are nothing but the facts. In this case, these words, which were spoken out, can be considered as facts. First of all, as the example, as the research, and when you have experienced it, their reception of the words itself is less. Out of 40, we could recall 8 or 10 or 12 words, right? That means there is so much of a transmission loss. And then connecting them, almost impossible. Therefore, creativity becomes such a difficult thing for most of us, unless we know how to be creative. Unless we know the nuances around it. So this is something which I wanted to share. So memory, as I would say, is one of the key things that you have seen, but is only one of the outcomes of superlearning program. Superlearning extends way, way, way beyond it. And therefore, this program is useful not only for the students, teachers, trainers, coaches, consultants, professionals, homemakers, you name it. Any area of your life where you need your level, heightened level of focus and heightened level of imagination, superlearning is going to help you. Within no time, you become a differentiator. Your performance gets to a different level and you can make your difference felt in that community. So with this, my part of the demonstration over here is over, and over to you, Ashish Bhai.
Thank you so much, Sanjeev ji and Deepti ji, for this wonderful presentation. And Sanjeev ji, I would also like to request you to share details with us how people can learn this, you know, because I'm sure we've got such positive and enthusiastic response from the people. If they want to learn and practice this in their lives, how can they do it?
Okay, over a period of last 8 years, having researched this program, having delivered this program in 12 countries, right from US, Canada, parts of Europe, Middle East, Africa, Southeast Asia, Nepal, and India, to people right from the top level of the organization to students, we have been able to now work on this program and kind of streamline it fairly well. So this program is, we run it through 5 sessions. Each session is about 45 to 60 minutes, where this is activity-driven program. You will learn the skill. Without a doubt, you will learn the skill. What you have seen today, you will be able to do it. No doubt about it. But that is not the key. Key is, as I said, you will be able to understand and dive deeper into what focus as a thing is, what imagination as a thing is, how do you enhance these ability, how do you sharpen these natural powers which have been gifted to us, and then how can you apply this in your respective area of work. You will be able to understand how can you elevate your level of subconscious and conscious, how can the two minds work together, and therefore you can yield the power that you have seen and even take it to a different level. You can be having a deeper understanding of those powers, and ultimately when you have more wealth of knowledge which is actionable by you, which is in your control, I'm sure you would agree with me that problem solving and decision making will get more refined. Our ability to reason out will be more defined, and it will be able to do. Now, okay, so this, as I have already said, anybody who is a professional or a business owner, trainer, speaker, coach, consultant, homemaker, parents, and students, if students have to perform well, score better, be more confident, if they are detached from a particular subject and they want to generate their interest in a subject, they want to be more creative, and they want to really have a better control and command over a particular subject, especially even one of the other areas which may not look direct, public speaking. Imagine those 40 words, she now can recall them in any sequence. If it is a part of her speech and they are more connected, she is ready to give a speech right away on those 40 words, right? She is able to answer those questions on those 40 words from here and there. So your ability to speak publicly, your ability to be a leader really goes through the roof, because your facts and figures are very much under your control. This helps you to enhance your self-confidence, self-esteem, self-worth. It reduces fear, worry, anxiety, and stress, because in this program, this is something that you start understanding. From where does the stress come? What are the reasons of stress? And if you are able to eliminate and work on them at a grassroots level, your anxiety, your ability to overcome fear and worry really gets enhanced. So this leads to exponential growth, whether it is your personal life and professional life. As I've already mentioned, the session contents will include all this. Once again, for the benefit of my friends, memory is a given. What you are seeing is a given. Therefore, I'm not elaborating it. What you are not probably, I've not been able to show you, but I would like to re-emphasize, are the areas which are the needle movers. Your ability to focus. The answering of the question, what is focus and how to focus? What is imagination? How to imagine? Apply them in day-to-day life with clear examples. I will be sharing with you case studies, and you will create your own case study, so you are able to apply this learning and skill and use it and make a difference in your daily life. We talk about mastermind, but do we really understand what a mastermind is? First of all, what is a mastermind? What is the power of a mastermind? And how do you yield that power? This, once you become a mastermind and you know how it works, this is directly related to the leadership concept. How can you rally people around you? How can you make large teams to work for you? Which is the key purpose of any leadership in any organization. How do people respect you and rally and work around, believe and trust you so that you can go to the next level? How do you improve your self-confidence? How do you get breakthroughs, genuine breakthroughs? And then we will have a wrap-up and open house session, Q&A, which will be there throughout the sessions. But we will have one session which will be wrapping up of all our learnings. These are weekly sessions, that is so, and you will have time to practice, and there will be session recordings which will be given to you just in case if you miss it, you will always have something to fall back around and then get that.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much for elaborating on the session content, Sanjeev Ji. Friends, we will be happy to hear from you if you have any quick question or comment. Yes, Hasan.
Yeah, it was really wonderful session. I have one question. As yes. We have done the practice on words, Can we try on one numbers, or I can share with TG the numbers, like a telephone numbers, and if she can, without seeing, if she can say the words, I mean, sorry, numbers, if we can try now.
Okay. Hasanji, this, the numbers is usually, numbers is an another skill, which is at a super advanced level. Okay. That is a skill, which is an extension of the skill. Okay. Because again, let me just, because this is a very valid question you asked, and for the benefit of the other audience, let me tell you, our brain is not designed to work on numbers. Let me tell you honestly. Therefore, even the smallest number puts too much of a strain of our mind. Correct? Even a small number, I can learn a 5-page essay, but 5-line number, extremely difficult. Correct? Because the brain is not designed to work on numbers, but since the humanity is working on numbers, we have to work with numbers. So that is an extension of the skill, which only, you know, if somebody is very, very keen to go ahead with that, well, we do that. But I would say that most of our job or work is done if we, because the idea here is, as I again said, how to process focus and imagination. Now, when we take it to the next level, the numbers can also be cracked because these powers can handle that. But then you have to take that. And to answer your question, Deepti doesn't do that. So she will not be able to do it. So without beating around the bush, she doesn't do it. So she won't be able to do it because then it has to be taken to a different level. But the phenomena remains the same. I hope I have answered your question.
Great. Thank you.
Hello, Dr. Nilofer.
There was, I think, Ashiji, there was one more question which came in, which I could see. But
Dr. Nilofer is going to. Go on. We can't hear you.
Thank you. I'm unmuted.
Yeah.
So my question was around the, you mentioned about problem solving and decision making. So I would like to understand a little more about that. That's one. The second is, when you talk about subconscious, is it long-term memory or short-term?
Okay.
So two questions.
The first one was related to the what was the question? Sorry, can you come back with the first question?
My first question was
problem solving, decision making. Okay, yeah, sorry. Okay, now decision making is all about developing alternatives, right, ma'am?
Yeah.
In our corporate life, we or even in our personal life, you always have choices. Alternative one, alternative two, alternative three, right? Now, what is, if you break down the alternatives depends upon the case facts, correct? What is the fact of the case? Based on the case facts, this is alternative one. Based on case facts, this is alternative two. Now, if we don't remember the facts, right? If we don't remember the facts, that means the quality and the number of alternatives will be compromised, right? If the quality and the number of alternatives is compromised, our decision making will be compromised. Right? So if our ability to handle more information accurately is correct, that means for any area where we have to make decisions, we can recollect the facts, and therefore based on the facts, we can draw multiple alternatives, more number of alternatives. The quality of alternatives will also be good because we will have more facts to substantiate those alternatives. And therefore, out of those alternatives, you are choosing one of them as your decision. So your quality of reasoning and decision making gets improved. Right, ma'am?
Right. And the problem solving?
So problem solving and decision making is part of that. For any problem, again, how do you solve a problem? You need to know what is the problem and what are the causes and what are the effects. Generally, what happens is you would say, oh, I missed out on that. I had forgotten that. I didn't remember that. Okay, this is something which I did not even take into my consideration set, right? And because you have missed out a very important point, and therefore the whole decision has gone awry for us. That is what it is.
Okay.
And then you asked me about the short-term and the long-term memory.
Yeah.
It largely depends upon how you want to use the skill. The skill is good enough to take it, convert your short-term memory into long-term memory. Now, for example, you may want to ask how long Deepti is going to remember these words. Now, the answer is, If these words are not important and only for demonstration purposes, she will flush them out right away. But if these are so important, suppose you tell me or you tell Deepti, okay, these are the words which I'm going to ask you on 31st of March, 2024. Okay, no problem. We'll come at the same time and she will repeat the words as it is.
Thanks.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you for those questions, Dr. Nilofer. And friends, people say that knowledge is power, but I believe it is not only knowledge, but when you apply the knowledge, then it becomes power. And the next 30 odd minutes of the session will be for those who want to act on this knowledge. You want to learn it and then apply it. So in case you are an action taker, please stay on in the session, else you are free to move on to something, watching the match or something else that you may want to do on a weekend. So if you are an action taker, please type AT in the chat box and stay on to hear the balanced part of the presentation. So if you are an action taker, please type AT. Thank you, Uma Maheshwar. Thank you, Hasan. Others, we want to hear from you. Thank you, Amit. Thank you, Rajenderji. So a lot of action takers are here and they will benefit from the information from the workshop that we have put together for you. So friends, if you are someone who wants to take action and take your life to the next level, then stay on. This workshop that we have put together will require an investment of time. As Sanjeev ji said, there will be 5 sessions for the workshop plus 1 bonus session. The bonus session we always keep so that you are able to integrate and assimilate all the learning into your life. That is our intent. Our intent is not only to feed you the information, but also help you apply. That is the reason we have these bonus sessions. So 5 plus 1, 6 sessions in all. So the total investment of time is about 6 hours. And these are the dates, 10th, 17th, and 24th September. This is on Sundays from 5 to 6 p.m. This is a slot which many people in our community find comfortable to attend and benefit from. I did this program with Sanjeev Ji about 2 years back, and I paid 10,000 rupees for the session. But Sanjeev Ji is a very generous person. For the benefit of Mindful Living community, the program comes to you not for 10,000 rupees, which is what I invested, but only for 4,999 rupees. So there is a 50% off that Sanjeev Ji has graciously offered. So you can remit 4,999 rupees to Ruchi on the number mentioned here and join the program. Once you have remitted the fees, please share the screenshot with us and type in the chat so that we can welcome you to the program. Sanjeev Ji, I will request you to share the details of the session once again for the benefit of everyone so that sure. They know what benefit they are going to get.
Yeah, thank you, Ashish Bhai. So basically, as I mentioned, what you have seen today, it involves a skill. And that skill will come to you. You will be able to learn the skill in these sessions. Rest assured, that is something, the easiest part. The more important part is about understanding of the key powers that our mind has, our ability to focus, our ability to imagine, and how these two supernatural powers help us to get ahead in life. So what are these and how we can work on these powers is something which is the soul and the spirit behind this program. How these powers can be helpful in learning, in building better level of competency in us and in our families, to our children and all that, is the third session, which will be about it. Fourth, leadership. How can we gain leadership position using these concepts? And one more powerful concept of mastermind. Understanding and really threadbare breaking mastermind into smaller elements, and what is the impact with respect to conscious, subconscious mind, and how can we be in that position of leadership where people can really work and we can handle large teams and make them work towards a goal in an aligned manner, is what mastermind is all about. And then in this process, how, where your self-confidence was and how can you take it to the next level. Understanding self-confidence from different angles. What are the various challenges to self-confidence? What are the various contributors to self-confidence? And then with the help of all this, getting new breakthroughs, asking new questions, and there will be open house which will assimilate our information and learnings that we have had during the program, any question and answers that you have in the next steps. So this is this program all about.
Thank you. Thank you, Sanjeevji, for sharing those details once again. And you've made it very, very exciting. And the best part about this program is once you learn these skills, they stay with you for a lifetime. You invest once, but the benefit that you get is for a lifetime. It's like planting a tree. You plant a tree once, but the fruits come throughout the life. Or you invest in shares and the dividends come for a lifetime. So similarly, you invest in this program and the benefits come to you for a lifetime. And as Sanjeevji mentioned, these sessions are going to be all recorded and these recordings are shared. Thank you. Thank you, Asan. Welcome to the program. I really appreciate your being an action taker. And in case you miss attending the program, we share the recording with you. This is one question we get asked often. When will the next workshop be? The next workshop will be in 2024. The last one was in 2022. And the reason we have repeated this is on popular demand. I was in Bangalore and we met with the community, Mindful Living community in Bangalore. And Sanjeevji also graciously attended that meet. And he was talking about the kind of work that he does. And our community members requested him to conduct the session. And that is the basis that we are having this again. And we will have this again in 2024 also. But don't wait till 24. Take action now so that you can have a strong finish to 23 and a strong start to 24. I love this quote. You know, sometimes there is no next time. It is now or never. So take that decision to act now. Sanjeevji has built a beautiful learning management system. So all the resources will go there and you will have access to the resources. And there'll be activities, assignments, and real life case studies that he mentioned about. So all of this will make this learning great fun. I don't think I had shared the best part with you. You can do this session along with a family member or a friend. So Hasan, you can invite someone to join this with you. It could be your son, it could be your wife, or it could be another family member. Anyone who joins this session will benefit by inviting one of their family members. The reason we did that is because last time, a lot of parents came to us and asked, can I get my child along with me? And you know, whether you want to get a child or spouse or any other family member, absolutely free. Just let us know the name and we'll be happy to have them join the program. A single session, somebody wants to drop in and check out whether this works for them or not. It is $2,499. Five sessions plus one bonus session, $4,999. And in case you would like to avail of a 1:1 coaching session along with Sanjeevji, then it is $9,999. Sanjeevji is an expert coach. As I mentioned earlier, he has worked at senior management levels with organizations like 3M, Toyota, Xerox, and he comes with very rich corporate experience. A lot of people have benefited a lot from his coaching sessions. So in case you would like to have 1:1 coaching session with him, you could go for the third option and remit a fees of ₹9,999. These are the details. These are also available in the chat with you, or you can take a screenshot of this and benefit. In case you would like to pay by credit card, you could click on this link and remit the fees by credit card. These details are also shared in the chat. And, you know, sometimes it happens that, you sign up. Rajni, thank you for your question. Is this in-person session or are you talking about coaching, Rajni? The coaching is 1:1. The coaching session is 1:1. And we'll be, in case we have not been able to respond to your question, Rajni will be happy to take it towards the end. And we are very happy to offer a money back guarantee for the program. So you come in, you attend the first session, you realize this is not something that is working for you. You Just tell us that you want to walk out of the program and we'll give you your full fees refund back. No questions asked. So that is completely on, so don't have to worry. This is a risk-free program for you. And the bonus is you get membership of the Mindful Living community. Many of you already are member of the community. Sanjeev Ji is a member of the community. And that's the best part. You get access to the trainer through these 365 days. You know, many a times we have attended training sessions, but we have never got access to the trainer again. A trainer has come, given the training and gone back. And, you know, you have some questions, you have some doubts, you don't know. But here you get a benefit of having this awesome community where we invite amazing, amazing speakers. We have a great lineup for September. And on 30th of September, we are inviting somebody who has scaled Mount Everest. He's a person like you and me, a corporate professional who climbed Mount Everest at the age of 46 years. An amazing story. So when you become a part of this community, you benefit from listening to these people. And we have exciting lineup for October, November, December. We'll be sharing that with you as the time comes. And many of you are aware that we take only limited number of participants in each batch. For this batch, we'll be taking in only 20 participants. So please take action quickly and join. We close registrations when we reach the batch of 20. So don't wait for somebody else to come in and then you missing out from the session. And for those of you who are signing today, you know, this is the lovely Mindful Living t-shirt that I'm wearing. You get the same t-shirt, not only for yourself, but for your friend or family member also. So you join the program today and you get these two very lovely Mindful Living t-shirts. Hassan has already availed of this offer earlier. It comes to you one more time. And, you know, this is the same t-shirt I wear. Very high quality fabric, and you will absolutely, you have these choice of colors. We will reach out to you and, you know, we will have them. The shipping is included in India, no charges for shipping in India. So it comes absolutely free of cost, limited period offer only for those who sign today. T-shirt offer is only for those who sign today. And so as I mentioned earlier, in case you would like to do a bank transfer, here are our bank account details. So this has got GPay, bank transfer details and the credit card details. So friends, the time to act is now. Act now. Take your life to the next level. We have recently landed on Chandrayaan. Take your life into a different orbit. So I'll finish here. Just before I finish, I'd like to share with you about two books which Sanjeev Ji very strongly recommends, which are the basis, which motivated him to kind of put this program together. Law of Success by Napoleon Hill and Acres of Diamond by Russell Conwell. You may check out these books and benefit from reading them. I'll bring the session to a close here and open it up to any question and answers that you may have. Thank you, Hassan, for your comments. Rashni, the course is on Zoom, one to many. The coaching is also on Zoom, one to one. We'll wait for another minute or so to see if you have any questions. Even if you have a comment, we'll be happy to take a comment. What are the names of the books again? Nagananda, we will share them on an email with you. The email will come out to you tomorrow. The names will be there. Maybe Sanjeev Ji, you could talk about the names once again. Law of Success and Acres of Diamond.
The Law of Success by Napoleon Hill is the same author of the book Think Rich and Grow Rich. But his first book, 1927 edition, was or 1929, Law of Success. I have loved it. And that is the one that I recommend to everyone. And the other one is Acres of Diamonds. It is an essay. It's actually not a book. It's an essay by Russell H. Conwell. And it was written way back in 1860. It's a small essay. And both the books are available free of cost online. So you can just type it, Google it, and you will get all of it together. Of course, Law of Success is a fairly, it is about 1200 page book. The Conwell's book is about 80 pages. So it's one time read. In one sitting, you can read through the whole book.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing that, Sanjeev Ji. So thank you for that question. Yes. Anyone else? Sanjeev Ji, any closing comments or anything you would like to share?
Yeah, what I would like to say is share here, thank you, Rashiji. Very, very thanks to you and to everyone here, because by being here, you have helped us to take our mission to the next level. Mine and Deepti's mission, along with Ashishji, is to help as many or to share this particular program or skill, our own inner powers, to as many people as we can. So just by being here, just investing your time and taking away yourself from other things, I think you have done a great service to us in taking this mission to the next level. We strongly feel that if people observe this, just by seeing it, they would know that this is the potential that we have. Each one of us has it and we can do it. That takes our confidence to the next level. And knowing or unknowingly, we may have triggered it off. So that's a great bonus for us. For that, a lot of gratitude to each one of you. At the same time, if you are signing up, we know that students, children, parents, people from different backgrounds who have really done it and mastered it, they may not use it on day-to-day life, but it's like a Brahmast. You use it when you need it, right? And you don't know what to do with it. So you are building that competency. You have it where you other things have failed, and you draw upon that information to get out of that tough spot. So this has helped it, and people's feedback on that really gives us a new high every time. So I am once again thankful to this community, and I once again welcome on behalf of Ashishji all those people who are not part of it to be part of this wonderful, amazing, helpful community. So that is all from our side.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sanjeev ji. Thank you, Deepti ji. And thank you everyone for joining this session today. Hope you will take the right decision which works for you and your family members and take your life to the next level. Thank you. Have a wonderful weekend. God bless.
Thank you.